You see, your brain is divided into two hemispheres.
Yeah.
Your left controls your right side, and your right controls your left side, and they're both tied together in a neat little package
by the totally awesome corpus callosum.
Well, you peel away that meninges layer, wipe off that cerebrospinal fluid, and you're looking right at the four lobes of the brain. You know the ones I'm talking about. Say it with me now.
Frontal, temporal, parietal, occipital.
And each one's got a very special job. Exactly what to do. As you're watching my disembodied head, your rods and cones are sending that stimuli to your thalamus, which routes it to your occipital lobe,
which of course processes visual information.
As you're listening to these words right here, the vibrations of the cilia down in your ears are sending those impulses along to your temporal lobe. And I know right now you're probably thinking, Al, how can these different parts of the brain communicate with each other? Well, to answer that question, I'm gonna have to break it down to a microscopic level.
This is a neuron, a funky, funky neuron. You got your axon on the one side, you got your dendrites on the other.
See, the dendrites receive a signal from another neuron, which then starts a chemical reaction in the nucleus, creating a nerve impulse which travels down a long, long myelin-coated strand. Transmitter molecules in the vesicle of the axon terminal. And those neurotransmitters jump a millionth of an inch across the synaptic gap and smash into the receptors of the dendrites of another neuron, connecting neurons to neurons to neurons to neurons all across your entire brain. The more you use
your brain,
the more connections you're gonna make, and the smarter you're gonna be. I'm talking about your brain. You gotta hand it to your brain. Yeah, that's your brain.